Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk a little bit more about the Invisalign records workflow through the dental practice app. And this is totally new. There is no more Invisalign photo uploader. Now it's the dental practice app that, and I do recommend that you have a definitive either iPhone or iPad that's in the office, and that's all that's on it is the Invisalign practice app. It's synced up within the office, and that way the doctor isn't using their own cell phone, because that's not HIPAA compliant. The team member isn't using their own cell phone. That's all that's on it. It's just for taking records. You have the dental practice app, and you go ahead, I'm just doing this based on if the patient's actually in the office. You can use the Invisalign practice app to use for virtual check-ins and things like that from home, but that's a different kind of story. So use the IPA or Invisalign practice app to create a patient chart. So you can put the patient's information in it. And the most important thing that you're gonna do when you're taking the records is you're gonna make sure you get that critical wide smile. And that is the smiling picture. And I know a lot of you don't pay attention to that. Oh, smile. You really want it a certain way. And we're gonna go over the why behind that. So let's go ahead and start there. Why do we use the Invisalign practice app to take photos instead of using your traditional fancy DSLR camera? Well, first of all, the records are just as good, if not better. I mean, I see doctors every single day using it. Those that don't, there's so much more training on the DSLR. Then you have to take the chip and you have to download it at the end of the day and upload it into the patient's charts. And that is a major hassle. So if you use this, it's gonna go straight into your Invisalign chart. The patient information's gonna go straight in, and you don't have that extra step where you have to download and upload. And during the extra step, there's also the risk of HIPAA compliance issues. So this is all HIPAA compliant. So that's why we do it. Number two, the critical wide smile is one of the 8 different photos that you're gonna get. And that one is so important so that you can use the treatment simulator or the in-face module. And I'm gonna explain what that is in a little while. Okay, then after you take the photos and the records, it's gonna go ahead and sync, and you're gonna go ahead and take your scan, take your x-ray. And then once you do that, by then you should already have your IOS or Invisalign Outcome Simulator ready to go. It takes a few minutes to upload once you take the scan and the photos. And within a few minutes after that, it's ready to go, and you can kind of show the patient a simulation of what their straight teeth would look like. Is this the ClinCheck? No. It's not showing you how we're gonna get there. It's gonna show you what it could look like and how you could get there. Makes sense. So it's not gonna say this is Invisalign moderate, this is 18 aligners. It's not a ClinCheck. All it is showing the patient their face with straight teeth. Now, the main thing you want to do when you do the critical wide smile is you want to make sure that your smile, I mean, a normal smile, you know, nice cheesy big smile, is nice. And there's a lot of things to get from a natural smile, but the critical wide smile is the only photo where we want to make sure that the patient's chief complaint and things that you see are reflected in there, so that when we do the outcome simulation and the in-face feature, that they can see that that chief complaint has been addressed. I'm not sure if that makes sense. So if the chief complaint is the gap between 8 and 9 or upper ones, that's pretty easy, because usually that's going to show up in a smile. But if the chief complaint, say, is a narrow smile, we want to make sure the smile is big enough that we can see those buccal quarters. If the chief complaint is the lower incisor crowning, we want to make sure when they're smiling, they're also showing their lower front teeth, which is a little different than a normal smile. So there's a special type of smile photo you want to take so that it can reflect better, not only in the outcome simulator, but also later in the ClinCheck, okay? So the other cool thing about the Invisalign practice app is that it can standardize, and it crops automatically, it centers things automatically, it orients automatically, so that it's a really quick learning curve. And pretty much anyone in the office, you can even teach high school students to do this. It is so, so, so easy. And like I said, it's going to capture the photos, sync them directly with Invisalign, take the wide smile so that you can use the in-face later in the outcome simulator and the ClinCheck. And then there's also a way that you can take a snapshot and send it to the patient if they want to see what it looks like. I do recommend later, that's kind of itchy, you know, they talk about that with Invisalign, but I think it's better to go ahead and export the actual ClinCheck in a HIPAA compliant way later. It'll go to their app. So hopefully that was helpful. I'm just really psyched about all the different ways that Invisalign has been innovating, and you know, good way to educate patients. And definitely you're going to have more sales using these resources, because it's a great way to educate patients. All right. Thanks so much.